Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good morning students. How do you do? How do you do? Okay. I hope all of you in a good condition. Today we will talk about the new topic for you. Yeah, the topic is about fraction. But before we talk too much about the fraction, let's pray together. Please say ta'awud and basmalah together. Wahid, isnain, thalasa. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Thank you. Guys, we already talk about this material last year. Pas kamu di kelas 3. If I'm not mistaken, we already talked about the basic concept of the fraction. What is the meaning of fraction? Something that is broken, ya, sesuatu yang pecah, remuk, redam, ya, dari sesuatu yang utuh, ya, kita bagi menjadi bagian-bagian yang kecil. But we must always remember, when we talk about the fraction, all of the parts is the same. Adil, ya, ketika kita membagi pecahan itu harus adil. Gak boleh ada yang berat sebelah, gak boleh ada yang lebih gede, ada yang lebih kecil. Semuanya harus sama. Ya, harus sama. So when we share the whole object or whole shape, we must divide fairly. Jadi membaginya harus adil banget. Kamu bisa melihat di gambar ini. Ya. Next, we will review again once again about the basic concept of the fraction. Ya. The above number is called numerator. Numerator in bahasa Indonesia is pembilang. And the bottom number is called denominator, or in bahasa Indonesia penyebut. Ingat, atas pembilang, bawah penyebut, tengah-tengahnya diberi tanda per. Ya. Okay, how to read ya the fraction? Ya, we can read 3/8. Gak usah pakai per, jadi langsung 3/8, 3/8. Ya. Look at the picture. How to draw the picture? Ya, this is the picture. Ya, related of the 3/8. Ini, ya. Jadi ini. Ya, the shaded area. 1, 2, 3. We have 3. So itulah pembilangnya. And the total parts, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Total partnya 8. Jadi bawah atau penyebut, denominator, is the total part that we have. Ya, jadi jumlah seluruh bagian itu di penyebut. Nah, the shaded area itu menyatakan pembilangnya. Next, this is 4/10. Ya, 4/10. Please count. 1, 2, 3, 4. We have 4 for the shaded area. Yang di atas ada 4. The total parts, dihitung aja, itu ada 10. So, the fraction is 4/10. Look at this picture. Ini ada beberapa gambar. Okay guys, please look at these pictures. We have some example here. Okay, for A. Nah, look at the picture of A. We will try to find out the fraction based on this picture. Ya. Yeah. Look at the shaded area. Yang di atas berapa itu? 1, 2, 3. So the numerator is 3. Atasnya 3. Please count the total parts that we have. 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, 4. So the fraction is 3/4. 3/4. Okay. Now for B. Ini yang B. Please count the shaded area. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There are 5. So, next please count the total parts that we have. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8. So, the fraction is 5/8. Yang lainnya kerjakan sendiri. Ya. Next, guys, we will also learn about how to compare two fractions. Nah, bagaimana membandingkan dua pecahan?
Please remember. Okay, I hope you still remember about the comparison symbols. Yeah, we have three symbols here. The first one is less than. This is less than, kurang dari. This is equal to, sama dengan. And this is bigger than or more than. Please remember, yeah. The mouth is always open to the bigger number. Mulut itu terbuka kepada bilangan yang gede. Itu berlaku juga di pecahan. Okay, we have the method. The method is cross multiplication. How to compare two fraction? Kita pakai perkalian silang yuk. Nah, we have two fraction here. Please compare which one that is bigger and which one that is smaller. Nah, this is 4 ninths, 4 per 9, bla bla bla, 2 sevenths. Nah, mana yang lebih gede? Caranya gampang. Ya, yeah, we can choose this one, this method. Okay, now we'll try to multiply. Ya, yeah, kiri bawah kalikan atas kanan. 9 times 2, the result is 18, 18. Kanan bawah kalikan dengan kiri atas, the result is 28. Betul kan? Nah sekarang bandingin 28 and 18. Which one that is bigger? Jelas 28. Maka tandanya kesana. Ingat, the mouth is always open to the bigger number. Itu yang diingat-ingat. Mulut terbuka kepada bilangan yang besar. Okay, guys, we have three problems here. Okay, we want to try to solve, to compare, yeah, which one that is bigger and which one that is smaller. Mana yang gede, mana yang kecil, yuk. The first one is 5, 8, blah, 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 4, 6. Yuk, kita kalikan aja. Nah, 8 kali 4. That is 32. Kanan, bawah, kiri, atas. 6 kali 5, there is 30. 30 sama 32. 30 and 32. Which one that is bigger? Jelas 32. Maka yang dicaplok yang sana. Gampang toh? Gampang. Next, number 2. 8 times 2. 16. 16. 4 times 4 also 16. Loh kok sama? Kalau sama, both of the fraction are same. Sama, berarti gedenya sama. Okay, next, the last problem. 10 times 2, the result is 20. 7 times 4, the result is 28. 20 and 28, which one is bigger? Jelas 28, maka ini tandanya kesana, ngik-ngik, berarti yang tengah-tengah sini gini ya. Tuh, nah ingat perkalian silang ya, kanan bawah ketemu kiri atas, kiri bawah ketemu kanan atas, jadi membentuk huruf X, maka dikatakan perkalian silang. Easy, please after this try to solve the problem ya, and I hope all of you understands about this material. Okay, thank you. See you next video. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Moms and Dads sedang mencari sekolah yang nyaman dan berkualitas untuk si kecil? Hari ini telah dibuka penerimaan siswa baru Playgroup dan TK Terpadu Budi Mulia 2 Seturan. Dilengkapi dengan fasilitas yang lengkap, playground luas berstandar Eropa, kolam renang, ruang kelas yang nyaman dan luas, ditambah dengan kurikulum bilingual Islamic Montessori yang dikemas menjadi kurikulum Budi Mulia 2, menjadikan belajar tetap menyenangkan. Sesuai moto kami, bersekolah dengan senang dan senang di sekolah.